right. Okay, I've got with me now Lindsay Stitch-Sturton, president of the Wonthaggi Rovers Football Club. Just for a few comments, and I want to ask Stitch a few questions. Lindsay, you'd be pretty proud of the boys getting up there 2 years in a row.
Very good, Tony. It's been a great effort by the boys. You know, we struggled this year early on with players with injuries and players leaving us, etc. I think we've got seven out of last year's grand final side that aren't playing today, so to get into it again today, it's a pretty good effort. We're extremely proud of our kids that come up through the third. We've got four boys out there today that can still play under 18 football next year.
Well, I thought that was the case. Well, no doubt, I think that the club's future is in its junior players, and you're to be congratulated on bringing the juniors through. Like a couple of them have already gone on to play with Gippsland Power this year. You'd be proud of those efforts. Very, like they would have left you a little bit short for the start, but now you've got them back, Joy Hart and Mark Bradley.
Yes, very proud of Joy and Mark. You know, it was hard during the year getting by without them, but at the business end of the season, they've come back to us, and we're very pleased. And I'll be looking for a big game from Mark Bradley today.
Oh yeah, I think so. Well, I had the pleasure of coaching him this year on the interleague team, and he's a great kid, and he's an ornament to the game. He's going to go places, that kid. That's
certainly,
for sure.
Certainly.
Today's team, Lindsay. Any injuries today? You got your team in 100% top shape?
Yes, we've got the best team we can put on the field. They're all 100%. And we have no excuses if we don't win it.
Okay, well, that's pretty fair. All right, well, I suppose, what can I say? Phillip Bond have just picked up two premierships. That'd be looking for the impossible. I've never done that three in a row. I've got a bit of an incentive there, don't you think?
They've got a big incentive to go for, but I believe our boys have got a bigger incentive to go for, and that's to keep the cup in Wonthaggi where it belongs.
Well, I'm sure. Look, I remember last year's game was a fantastic game. It was played purely on skills. And I wouldn't expect anything different today. Would you say that?
No,
too?
I expect a very, very, very entertaining, very skillful game. And I think our boys will win it through their mental toughness. Like last week, they copped a hell of a biffing from Dalston, seven players off with the blood rule, and they just kept on putting their head down, their bum up, and playing football.
Well, I think that's the only.
They are mentally tough.
Well, that's good. Well, look, Lindsay, all the best, and. All the best to your team. You know, I'm a Phillip Island man. I'm wishing them the best, but let's hope we have a good game. Okay?
I hope it's a great contest.
Yeah.
Thank you very much,
Thank
Tony.
You very much, Lindsay. Thank you.
It's all the same question.
We'll see if they can win this. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're ready to start proceedings for the Bass Valley Senior Grand Final to be played between Wonthaggi Rovers and Phillip Island. This is a replay of last year's Grand Final when Rovers won by 1 point. And basically the sides have changed a lot. There's a lot of the juniors that have come through. I've been, as you heard previously from the president of Rovers, I've only got seven from last year's premiership team, so they're relying on their juniors. And of course juniors have got plenty of pace in their legs, and Phillip Island have done the same thing. They've got a lot of young players out there with plenty of pace. We should be in for a crackerjack game. The ground's in top condition. There's some great footballers out there. May the best team win. And I know I've got Darryl Purvis here with me from Rovers. He hopes Rovers wins, and I hope Phillip Island wins. But let's hope we have a good, clean game. The umpires for today are... let me see... Umpires for today are Peter Mayer and Travis Donnelly. We're ready to go. The bounce of the ball. Patching against Gilliland. Patching gets the ball down. Fernanda knocks it on. Taken by Piera. Fernanda then follows it up across to the wing. He's got plenty of pace, this bloke. Gets a left foot kick to it and finds Niven. A lovely pass to Niven on the half forward line. Gets a short kick in, and it's marked by Sean Sturton. Sean Sturton gets it across to, young Chris White, and the ball's been paddled out of bounds in the half forward line. Already a lot of pace in the game. Boundary umpire to throw it in. Gilliland against against John Evans by the looks of it. No, patching came across, Danny Williams across the back. Picked up by Fernand already. He's had three possessions. Kicks the ball into the goal square. Tell you what, it's a great kick and marked by Nevin. Right in the goal square. Oh, that was a wonderful play from Fernando. I'll tell you what, he's got plenty of legs, that bloke, and the Rovers are going to have to watch him. Nevin kicks straight through the middle. The first goal of the day is on the board to Phillip Island. Phillip Island, one goal. Rovers yet to score. Game's been going about 1 minute. Bit early to tell. Darryl, what do you think?
The ball, the game's going to be won out of the centre. It all depends who gets it out, whether it's Rovers, Phillip Island.
Yeah, I tend to agree. It's the centre line players that are going to make the big difference. Out of the centre is an important thing because both teams have got runners, Darryl.
And both teams have got good forward line players. Mm.
Ball back in the centre with the umpire. Sunshine out here today. There's even shadows on the ground. It's turned out to be a beauty. Umpire bounces the ball, patching against Gilliland. Gilliland got that knock there. Straight out to Bradley, who tapped it on. That was Grace, I think, Tazari.
Hooper.
Hooper in the middle of the pack, taken by Cowburn. Gets a quick handball out.
Young White
gets the ball straight to Johnny Evans. Long kick in a half forward. There's no one there. Yes, there is. There's a bloke by the name of Piera there. Little chip over the top, and he's found... who has he found? He's found Scott Huther all by himself. My God, you don't let a bloke like Scott Huther get out by himself. He's usually a deadly kick. He's played all his football on this ground, Darryl. He knows where the goals are here. Scott Huther comes in, lines it up. 10 metres out on a bit of an angle. Follows through. No mistake about it. Straight through the middle. Second goal of the island. Two goals. Rovers yet to score. Well, bit of a quick start there, Darryl. Both times it's coming out of the centre, as you said. Game is very quick, perfect conditions. But the Island have got the aid of a slight breeze. Patching this time gets a half a knockdown. No one in particular, the ball's on the ground, players trying to get it out. Great endeavour by everyone there. And it was Alan McKellar comes out of the... Is that McKellar? Yeah, he comes out of the bottom of the pack. Well, he gives his all every Saturday. Umpire bounces the ball. Patching again. Oh, really, nobody again. Everyone's in there trying to get the ball out. Smothered over, and the umpire says, I'll have it, thank you very much. Bounce the ball. Beautiful bounce. Knocked down by... Gilland. Danny Williams throws himself in. He can't get the ball out. Tell you what, the umpire's going to have to pull a free kick out of here in a minute just to open up the play. Bounce of the ball. Patching this time gets a nice jump and a nice knock. Once again, Gisbert's quick kick out off the ground. Being chased by Rod Tack. Still following up young... Chris Ross gets the ball on his left foot, over across to the wing. Gisbert's is there, swings around on his left foot, drives it into half forward line, and who's there? I'd have to pay the mark. And that is young Duggan, one of the juniors. No, he thought about the pass, he's gone back, he might have to have a shot now. No, he's gone short and he's found Huther. Huther's causing trouble. Of course, they haven't had a chance to get it to Paul yet because he hasn't been up there. Scotty Huther to have a shot. About 45 metres. He'll kick from close to the 48 metre line. On quite an acute angle, but he's on his left foot, which is on the right side from where he's kicking. Follows through the ball. Oh, no mistake. He's gone right through the middle. He's kicked two in 2 minutes. Well, the Island looking a little bit ominous here at the moment. Darryl, have you got anything to say at the moment?
Nah, just too quick in centre bounces. If they don't get it forward, I don't know what they're going to do. Otherwise, maybe a change into the centre ball players, which moves will leave that up to the coach. Maybe Grayson in the centre.
Right. Well, let's see what happens. It's only the first quarter, and I've seen teams come back from a long way down the first quarter before, Darryl.
Well, Phillip Island, I think they are renowned for jumping Rovers. Yeah. They've done it last year, and I don't think Rovers will even be concerned, even though they were last year. Six goals down at half-time.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, the ball comes out from Jones to Williams to Gisberts to Gisberts, looking for Piera. Two of them went up, no talk there, but sharked by Fernanda, and hits Huther on the chest again. They're going to have to do something at full-back, Rovers. They're in trouble there. Their full-back has been behind by 3 or 4 metres all the time. Scotty Huther's lining up for his third. He kicked 10 in the grand final a few years ago when he was playing with Blues. This is a dream start for the Island. If he shoots this through, it'll be 4 goals to 0. Oh, he hasn't missed. He's piercing the middle every time. Scoreboard is Phillip Island, 4 goals. Rovers haven't seen the ball into the half forward line yet. But the pace of Fernanda is showing out already, and he hit Huther with a beautiful pass there, Darryl.
Too good. They're going to have to match him up.
Yep. Bounce of the ball. Infringement. Centreline infringement against Rovers. Taken by Phillip Island. Big patch. He'll kick it long. Kicks it in the centre half forward. Atkinson over the top. Misses it. Picked up by
Glenn Burt.
Little short kick into the centre. Oh, Danny Williams backed his judgement. Hal didn't have the ball, throws himself back into the pack. Umpires call for a bounce up. Bit of desperate play there. He nearly took the mark off there, Danny. Bounce of the ball. Oh, big punch on there by Pete Cleary. Off the ground. That was clever play. Open up the game. Danny Williams leading in the race for the ball. Shannon Logan made position. Laurie Howes made position coming down from centre half back. Gets the ball and passes it straight to Young Ross. Young Ross has taken a nice mark across the half back line in front of his opponent in Duggan. Short pass to Rod Burton. Burton on the left foot. Drills it up to the wing. Tack going for the mark. Oh, beautifully tackled there by the Phillip Island player. The umpire's call for a bounce. One of the umpires there talking to Danny Williams. Looks as though he's got a cut across his face. Blood rule, he's going to have to go off the ground. So play will be held up for a minute until he comes off, gets the blood patched up, and then comes back on again. I don't think Danny can afford to be off the ground for too long. He's an inspiration to the team, and the Whale comes on. Alan Jeans coached the Whale when he represented New South Wales some years ago, and when Alan was speaking to the players yesterday, he made great reference to the Whale, saying what a great player that he's been and a bloke of his age to still participate in senior level. It's an absolute credit to him. So you'd have to admit, an effort, what a great effort, 42, 43 years of age, Darryl.
Is that your age, Tony?
Yeah, it is. Yeah, so he's got good legs, I haven't. The ball sharked out of the pack, kicked up long into the forward line. Justin Paul out in front, gathers the ball beautifully, has a snap with his right foot, and it goes through for 1 point. He just looks class, Justin Paul. He is class. He's won the league best and fairest. So we've got the two best full forwards in the comp here. So we should be in for a treat today. Young Ian Ricks is going to kick the ball back in. Kicks it to the outer side, a good 60 metres out. Patching goes from nearly held the mark. Young Pierre throwing his weight through the packs. Ball gathered up there by young Burton on the left foot. Looking to Hooper, and Hooper's got it. Oh, it's a crackerjack pace here. Hooper's got every opportunity to kick a goal from there. His umpire's thrown him around a bit on an angle, but he's a class player, this kid. Tim Hooper, I understand he's under a bit of a cloud with the flu, but He showed that he's a class player there. Unfortunately, he's missed the goal, only 1 point. The crowd will tell us that all the time because all the Phillip Island lot are up there. Rixie's got the ball again, is it? Oh, it looks like Laurie this time. Yeah, Laurie Hower. He's looking for Shannon. Oh, Gisbert's off the ground. Joy Hart contested and the ball's been rushed out of bounds. Out of bounds under the light tower. Rovers half forward line. Scores are Phillip Island, 4 goals straight. Rovers 2 points. Ball taken out of the scrum by Peter Cleary. Big kick in the centre forward. Whale uses his body well. Duggan tried to match it, but it's young White gets the ball on the Sturton. A little pass, looking for Hart, for young Jai Hart. Only 16-year-old, swings around on his right foot to no one in particular. Cesari gets the ball, a quick handball out to onto Hooper. And he's going to have a shot for goal on the left foot. Justin Paul's made plenty of space for himself. Can he trap it before it goes out of bounds? No, he can't. Rovers are starting some signs are running on now. They're starting to get out of that lethargic look that they had for the first 5 minutes. They've done all the attacking the last five. Knocked down by Patching, snapped by Grace, Hooper. Marked by Hooper, runs into an open goal and bangs it through for the Rovers' first goal. It was good play, that. Very good play. The scoreboard now, Rovers their first major, 1-2, trail Phillip Island, 4 goals. Straight. Well, that was a little bit better play. Your running plays are starting to come into the game now, Darryl. Made all the difference.
Interesting to note, Tony, the way that Phillip Island's jumped Rovers. They done it in last year's grand final. They done it in the 91 preliminary final that Rovers played down at Inverloch. They jumped them by 5 goals, and that's where they stayed. Hopefully, the Rovers have got the fight back to come back, and they have done in the past.
Well, they may well do, Darryl. The time will only tell now. But you are right. We have jumped Rovers in the last couple of occasions in finals.
Maybe it's just the nerves.
Well, it could be too. Pye bounces the ball. Infringement again. This is silly. It penalises the team. Rovers have got an extra man in. They've got to do something about that. Taken by Patching. Patching's got the loose man in Jones. And Jones takes the mark. Across the wing. Another short pass on. Niven in front. Our young Lovett trying to trap the ball. Gisbert's in front of him. Niven collected high, I felt. Ball scrummed up. The umpire's going to bounce it. Bounce between wing and half forward. Phillip Island attacking zone. Lovely bounce by the umpire. Niven gets the knockdown. Taken by Lindsay. Handballs it out of bounds. The ball is out of bounds. Close to the wing. Members side. Niven and Bradley in the ruck. Gisbert's off the ground. Not clean. Taken by Cleary. Quick snap into the forward line. There's only one player. There's Huther and 2 Rovers. What can happen? Huther traps the ball in front of him. Pushed out in front. Some desperate football. A handball comes out. Fernandez got the ball. This is dangerous when he gets it because he doesn't miss. Fernandez dubbed it through. It's a great play by the Elno. Desperate there. They push the ball out and that's good discipline play. Danny Williams is back on the ground. He's had his bleeding attended to. So the score is 5 goals straight. Phillip Island Rovers 1-2. Halfway through the first quarter. Gee, it's been at a crackerjack pace. It's all right getting jumps in grand finals, but I'll tell you what, they're always hard to get back. You'd rather be with a team than have to come back. Catch-up football's not good. Here it goes again. Taken by Ricks. Long kick into full forward. Huther waiting down the back of the pack. Runs into an open goal, and thank your mother for coming. Another goal of the island. 6 goals straight to 1-2. He's kicked 4, I think, Huther. This is unbelievable. We've only been going 10 minutes.
15 minutes.
15 minutes. Well, the Island are looking bloody ominous. I don't care what anyone reckons, them. I mean, they're looking dangerous at the moment, and Rovers can't afford to let them get too big a break, Darryl. You know, your catch-up footy these days isn't good. They start to lose their confidence. Player bounces the ball. Bit of shenanigans. I think they've got the tag on Fernanda. Chris White's on Fernanda. I got to try and stop him. The ball take. Oh, Cowburn reads the ball out of the pack. Gets a left foot pass down. Niven taps it on to Piera. Clever football. A little pass across the ground and Duggan's got it. And he'll kick it from there. He can kick that distance. But the tag's on. I mean, they had to stop Fernanda. Young Chris White up from the thirds is going to have to run with Fernanda all day. Yeah, he's causing havoc. Duggan, the big kick. It's looking good. Looking good. Another goal to the Island. Gee. 7 goals straight to 1-2. We've only played 15 minutes. There's a little bit of panic setting up in there. There's Rovers players talking, screaming out at others and pointing directions. It's not a good sign. I'm just a little bit worried if I was a Rovers supporter at this stage. 6 goals to peg back in 15 minutes, the start of a game. Oh, well, umpire bounces the ball. Big punch out there by Mark Bradley. Down to Cowburn, who missed it, scrubbing in the pack, who's that Rovers play? Timmy Hooper throwing himself in, trying to get the ball out, but he was tackled very, very well by the Phillip Island bloke. I think it was young Jarvis Weston. Bounce of the ball. Patching. Okay. Taken by Hooper again. He's got quite a few, but there's Laurie here. Oh, the Phillip Island player was pushed out, yes. Crackers has got it. Crackers, McIntosh, little pass. Oh, not a good pass, Crackers. Out to Danny Williams. And the ball's been, looks though, out of bounds. No, it was a bad pass. They had loose player there. Should have hit Danny on the chest. Well, we're not all perfect in footy these days. We all make mistakes. Boundary umpire throws the ball in. Big knockout there by Patching to Fernando, who gathers the ball as if it's about 6 foot wide, kicks the ball down towards Duggan, overruns it, and the ball's been forced over out of bounds by Fernanda again, like he followed up. He's there before he even knows it. Umpire throws it in. Johnny Evans in the ruck this time, not down to anyone in particular. A knockout of the centre comes out. Who's running after it here? Burton. Young Burton's got the ball in front of him, but sharked away by Gisbert, so he snaps on the left foot, and it's another goal. It's another goal of the Island. They're doing what they like out here. They're just playing games with Rovers at the moment, doing what they like. The scoreboard, 8 goals straight. Have a look at that for a score. 8 goals straight to 1-2. That's really something to have a look at. 8 goals straight in the first 15 minutes of footy, 15, 17 minutes of football. I've bamboozled the Rovers. I'd like to see them get out of this one, Darryl. It's starting to look at... I'd be worried if I were you. Hey?
Definitely worried.
Yeah, I
definitely
thought so. Worried.
Too fast, too good.
Ah, yes, that's very true. Another infringement. This time it's against Phillip Island. These players should know better than this. Bradley handballs out, handballs the ball to Burton on the left foot. Laurie Howard drops back and takes the mark. Kicking to positions bad by Rovers at the moment. Kicks it, Burton got the sit and he'll take the mark. Got a bit of class this Burton. On his left foot.
Looks for tack.
Looking for tack.
No.
Oh, punched away Lovett. By across to Brett Lovett. Not Hooper. Brett Lovett, Ross Lovett and Hooper. Oh, this Hooper is a dangerous customer.
Come on,
Hoops. To say they need this goal would be an understatement, wouldn't it?
Definitely, they need a couple.
They need a couple more before quarter time, I'd say. It's a goal. No worries about that. Yeah, straight through the middle. Good goal of Tim Hooper. Tim is giving him the bite up the forward line. They just haven't got enough people helping him, Darryl.
20-minute mark.
20-minute mark.
Six goals down.
Yep. Score 8-2. Plenty of time left in this game. We'll never forget when Brisbane Bears come back from 45 points down, Darryl, to win a game against Hawthorn earlier on this year. Now they're playing off in a final tomorrow against Carlton. Umpire bounced the ball. Mark Bailey gets a big knock. Matty Cowburn handball over the top to Ricks. Ricks on the right foot. Drives into centre half forward. And here he is again. Oh, he missed it. He had the sit and everything, Scotty Huther. Fernanda. Oh, he's nearly got caught. He did get caught. It's not often that happens. Who's got it? Young White. Yeah, he's tagger. He's got the ball. Passes it to Sturton. Sean Sturton's got the ball. Kicks it up across the wing on the outer side. Laurie Howe goes up and takes an easy mark. He had it all away. Laurie Howe brings the ball across the centre of the ground. Oh, Burton missed an easy mark. Danny Williams pushed his... It was Jonesy to Johnny Evans out to Gisbert's. Gisbert doesn't know where to go. He's got no room. Finally gets it on the left foot. Kicks it high in the Huther direction. The ball hits the deck. Can anybody get it? Duggan's there. Tax got it, handballs it to Lindsay, tapped on to Lovett. Lovett gets the ball straight to Ricks, breaks it, couple of tackles, has the ball smothered, took too long. Oh, a bit high around the neck, I thought. Anyway, Burton's in there trying to get the ball out. Jones taps it on again. Oh, there's some close hard in play. Lindsay taps it, Lovett tries to get a kick. Cowburn tries to get a kick. There's pressures on here like you wouldn't believe. And the umpire's going to have to ball it up. It was a great effort on all players from both sides there. There was a lot of pressure in that. There were smothers and tackles all over the place. Umpire bounces the ball. Good bounce. No one really gets any decisive knock out of that. Fernandez there at the bottom of the pack. Handball's out in front of him. White's right on his hammer. Gisbert kicks it off the ground and it's out of bounds on the full. A Rovers free kick. Taken by Sean Sturton. He runs across the face of goal, transfers the play, across to the other side, across to Hooper, and Hooper's got the ball. He's playing well, Hooper. He's kept him in the game. On his right foot, he's looking for Jai Hart, and the ball dribbles out of bounds. Out of bounds on the outer side of the Wonthaggi Oval. With the scoreboard, Phillip Island leading 8-2, Rovers 2-2. First quarter coming to a close. Good knock down there, taken by Sturton. And lovely pass being marked by Simon Gilliland.
On to Sturton.
Back to Sturton on the left foot, looking for his forward. And a nice mark taken by Patching, just dropping across the half-back line. Short pass, smothered too close to the man in the mark, could be costly. McIntosh gets it to Danny Williams. Danny Williams with a quick kick, looking for Evans. Knocked down in front of the pack, taken by Bradley. Quick handball taken by Evans into open space. Sturton running after the ball, and it's going to run out of bounds on the 50-metre line. Half-forward flank for Phillip Island. Phillip Island in attack. All thrown in. No one got a knock there. The bad throw in by the boundary umpire. Lovett gets a quick handball out to Burton. Danny Williams punches the ball away from his opponent. Jonesy backs up beautifully. Gets a quick handball out to Jarvis Weston. A quick kick looking for Huther. He's got him. He's got him, all right. He's got him. I'd say Huther will have a go for the goals from here. The way he's been kicking him, say this is a chance as well. He's going to have a ping at it. Scotty Huther lining him up. 45 metres, very acute angle on the wrong side of his kicking foot. Kicks the ball. Oh, this looks great. This is straight through the middle. There's nothing going to go wrong for Scotty Huther today. That's a sensational goal. That's uplifting. Great goal, Scotty Huther. Gee, he knows this ground, he knows where those sticks are. Scoreboard, Phillip Olin, 9 goals straight. What a scoreline. Rovers, 2 goals, 2. 40 points of difference. Pyre bounces the ball. Bradley misses the knock to Patching. Evans shows strength through to Weston. Quickly onto his right foot. Into open territory across the half forward line. Tack chasing the ball with Niven. Niven, a quick kick on his right foot. How's the ball going to bounce? It's bounced through! It's a goal! What a great goal of Niven for Phillip Olin. That is just great stuff. Phillip Olin really slapping him on the board. 10 goals in one quarter, like he's like seeing that in league football. Well, everything's going right. The ball broke about 4 times, Darrell, and finished up going through and beat the full back to the line. Unbelievable stuff. Phillip Olin, 10 goals straight. Rovers, 2 goals, 2. Have they set up a match-winning lead? It certainly looks like it. Very quiet up here in the Rovers grandstand at the moment. The umpire bounces the ball. Patching gets a good knock. Out to McKellar. McKellar, quick handball out. The tackling's strong here. Gisbert gets it out to Jones. They're running away with it, the Olin. A lovely pass. Hits Duggan right in the chest. It's open up. He's looking for Huther. Can he get him again? No. At this time, he's cleared the ball to fullback and gets it to Lovett. Lovett, long kick, looking for Gilliland. Misses the ball. Laurie Howard, the ever-reliable. He goes one way. Sees Shannon Logan all by himself, and he finds him. Handball over the top. Oh, a bit of an ordinary handball. Gets it back, though. Breaks the tackle. Looking for someone to kick it to and finds Pete Cleary on the half-forward flank. It's Pete Cleary. Driving kick into the forward line. Niven flies high. The ball's been pushed out of bounds. Well, it's been all Phillip Olin. My God, it'd have to be a fair bit of time on this quarter. There's been 12 goals kicked. Our cameraman's got a sore shoulder. I've got a sore voice box. The umpire throws it in. Knocked down in front of the pack. No one out clear with the ball. Comes back to Gisbert. Gisbert's on his right foot. Drops it back in and it's been marked by Young Ross. Young Ross on the right foot. Swings the play across the ground to Burton, who tapples it out of bounds. They've really got nothing much going for them at the moment, Rovers. I suppose the thing they're hoping for, the quarter time comes quickly enough. Niven gets a big punch down in front of the pack, being chased by, I forget who that was, but he's got it by Jai Hart and Wintle, that was, and Burton rushes it out of bounds again. Bayer throws the ball in. Knockout from behind, no one in particular. The umpire said it was held to him. He said, give me the ball and I'll bounce it. Umpire bounces the ball. Mark Belly flies up. Big knockdown. McKellar quickly on the right foot, looking for Tassari. Tassari's punched away by Weston. Hoop misses the ball, gets it across to Gisberts on his unfamiliar foot, the right foot down in there. Bradley, one hand, brings it down. He's a great player, this kid. He hasn't played with the team for a while, and he might take a quarter or so to adjust. On the left foot, kicks it long, across to the centre line. Laurie Howe sets himself to knock it down. It comes out in the open to Jones. It seems to be Phillip Olin plays. Oh, beautiful smother there by Rovers. The opportunity was there. It was well smothered by Tassari. Byer throws it in. Patching knocks it down. McKellar tries to burst through the pack. Gets a handball out towards Hooper. Fernanda, using his pace, ducks and weaves. Gets a handball. It's smothered. He's going to get a free kick by the looks of it. He might have got high, a bit high. Yes, it's a free kick to young Fernanda. Centres the ball beautifully to Gisbert's in the centre. Made a lovely position. It was a top pass. Gisbert's kicks it long, looking for the high flies. No one comes down. But Niven punches it on. Is there anyone down on the ground? Is there anybody? Piera rushes it, and the first point on the board goes to Phillip Olin. It's rushed. Well, they've ruined the scoreline. It's gone from 10 goals straight to 10 goals one. Rovers, 2 goals two. 8 goals, 47 points of difference coming on the quarter time. Ball brought back into play by Sturton. Straight to Duggan. Oh, he pushed in the back, I thought, and the umpire saw it that way. It's a free kick to Duggan. No one told him to wait anyway. He's going to have a shot for goal or look for lead to someone. young Duggan comes in. Big kick for goal. Oh, it's gone across. No, it's through for a point. Through for a point. So it's exactly 8 goals of difference. 10 goals 2 to 2 goals 2. Getting close to the end of the first quarter. The fullback kicks it to himself. Has a bounce. Handballs it on it. Almost smothered. Regathers it. Short pass in. Kicks it straight to a Phillip Island player. They're kicking their disposal. Rovers is disgraceful. Ball taken by Rovers. Good smother there. And the ball's held in. The umpire says, thank you very much. I'll have that ball. And he's going to bounce it. Bounce it. So siren goes. Quarter time. Quarter time scores. Phillip Island 10 goals 2. Rovers 2 goals 2. Well, Darryl, I need some expert comments. What have you got to say?
They're just too good, Tony. Well, getting the ball out of the centre. They've got too many runners. What can we say, Tony? They are too good.
Yeah, well, at the moment, that's the way it looks. They're just moving the ball quickly. They've got players at the bottom of the packs. They're tackling hard. They're just playing the better football, I believe. And I've left right Lovers sort of shell-shocked. And, they've had to come back from behind before, but this just looks a little bit more dangerous. It's an 8-goal situation. They've got to put in a big quarter this quarter. Otherwise, if Phillip Island go in 10 or 12 goals in front at half time, I think that's going to make your task pretty hard. Wouldn't you agree?
Well, I think it'll be very hard from here, Tony, but we'll go down and have a listen to the boys
have
got to say
sure.
At quarter time.
Okay, come back and tell me. Thank you. We'll take a break for a minute. We'll be back with the second quarter. Okay, we're ready to start the second quarter. I'm waiting for Darryl to come here to see what their coach said. And before we start, so Darryl's here now. Darryl, what did Greg Hosking have to say?
He's just more or less said that they've got to go back, start from scratch. Their endeavour for the ball hasn't been great enough. And that's actually showed, hasn't it, Tony?
Yeah, it has.
The Island's been first in for the ball and they're just running too quick. I don't know whether he's made any changes, but I think everybody from the Island's playing well.
Yeah.
And you're not going to stop all of them anyway. So.
Yeah. Oh, well, let's see if they can make a change of the game in this half. The umpire bounces the ball. Patching gets the knock. Down to nobody in particular. McCullough gets the ball. He's trying to barge through. He gets a quick handball out. Tassari missed it. Taken by Weston. Weston handballs it to Laurie Howe. Laurie Howe, a beautiful pass. Hits Cleary. Lovely pass. Good positioning. Cleary with the ball. Big kick. Inner centre half forward, Johnny Evans setting back, misses the mark, but Piera handballs. He wasn't ready for it, Cowburn. Piera recovers, gets a quick kick up the Niven, and good mark by Atkinson. Big Aki takes a good mark there. Comes out to the member side wing. Patching flies, over the back, everyone missed it. Rixey gets the ball, Danny Williams took his eyes off the ball just for a split second. Ball smothered, Jonesy gets it. Goes for a handball, gets it across to Ricks. Very high ball, but it's travelled 10 metres. Who can take the big mark? Everyone flies. Piera down again. Gets a handball up to Ricks. Ricks a handball across to Gisbert on his left foot. He's going to have a shot for goal. He has a ping at the goals. It's looking good. No, it's just touched on the line. And now it's a free kick. He was pushed. He was pushed by Huther. A good play by
Fisher.
By Fisher. Short pass out and finds young Chris Ross. Chris Ross, another short pass. And finds young Ross Lovett. A little bit high too. The umpire's just told him to play. Ross Lovett plays on, dummies a handball out to the members' wing. Everyone flies for the ball, no one takes the mark. A bit high, free kick to Ross. We nearly hit him across. Umpire calls the advantage. McKellar gets it across to Burton. Burton to Bradley. Bradley off on his left foot. Shoots it into the forward line. Is a good play here, mate. And it's marked by Hooper again. Well, Shannon's going to have to play him a bit tighter. He's kicked one, I think. Or has he kicked them both? Yeah, well, he's kicked at least one. Well, he's only kicked the two. Well, Hooper's he's a left footer on the wrong side. He runs around. Has a shot. And 1 point as a result. So the score is Rovers 2 goals 3, Phillip Island 10 goals 2, first minute and a half of the second quarter. Laurie Howard to bring the ball back into play. Some leads being made. I think you look for Patching. Patching's matched up against Paul. Yes, that's the way he's going. A beautiful kick. Oh, Gisbert's flew like a bird but come down with nothing. Lovett gets the ball, little short kick in here to Grace, and Grace takes the mark. Well, Gracie can kick that. He's going to have to kick it from the 50-metre mark. It's definitely the scoring in that, Wayne. Oh, no, he's gone for the short kick across to Burton. Burton can play on here and drive it long. He's a beautiful kick, but oh, no, he's kicked it offline and punched by Shannon Logan. Good defensive play, punched through for one behind. The Gippsland Building Approval scoreboard now. Rovers 2-4 and Phillip Island 10-2. Do you like that, Darryl? Laurie Howe, big kick. Oh, 55-metre kick. Beautiful kick. Matty Cabo misses the mark. Danny Williams scouts the packs. Gets the ball back to Danny. A little bit slow, nearly caught. Julian Wintle tried to get the ball. Pierre is causing trouble. He's got a lot of pace, Pierre. Reads the play well. Gisbert, they both went for the ball, those two. It was good, clean football. Oh, Fanana was sheer pace. He should have handballed it across to Duggan. He did. He kicked it to him. Duggan's looking for the short pass here, and he's going to pay the mark. I would have paid it. No, he had a decent grab at that. He had the ball well and truly. Peter Cleary, 15 metres out of goals. Very straightforward shot for goal. But oh, Fernandez's pace was just incredible in Darryl.
Nobody will stop him.
Cleary shoots. The umpire just watches it go over the top of his head. And another major goes through for the Phillip Island Bulldogs. The Gippsland Building Approval scoreboard now. Phillip Island, 11-2. Rovers, 2-4. Well, Phillip Island are worrying Rovers. Rovers have got to peg them back this quarter. Otherwise, it's good night, Dick. You can't be coming back from 15 goals down at half-time. By to bounce the ball. Gilliland gets a knockdown. McCallis caught. The tackle's good. I don't know what this Alan Jones did yesterday, but I'll tell you what, he's made this team really perform. The other two have, and they're doing the same. Bounces the ball. Gilliland gets a knockdown. No one in particular. Taken by Sturton, but straight to Jarvis Weston, who takes a mark over. Grace isn't fit, I don't care what anyone reckons. Kicks the ball out to Laurie Howard. Taps it on to Brad Walker, who misses it. Grace handball too slow. Jarvis Weston handballs out to Jonesy. Jonesy onto Gisbert's is running right. Kick smothered. Shouldn't happen in football. Taken by Gilliland. Oh, a very heavy push at the ball by McKellar. But taken by Ross, young Ross. He kicks the ball off the ground out to Gilliland. He's going to, you know, he doesn't. He finishes up shepherding for nobody. Taken by Sean Sturton. Handballs it back to young Ross. Ross on the left foot. Kicks it down. Danny Williams takes the mark. So if he plays on Danny Williams. He's looking for Duggan, and he's got him. He's got him. Beautiful play by Phillip Island. Duggan's got to have a, he's got to ping it up. He's got to ping it up. Young Steve Duggan lining up for goal. 45 metres, dead in front. He should kick this. Follows the ball through. It's going to lob in the goal square. And is it touched on the line? It is touched on the line. The umpire held us all in suspense there. A minor score to Phillip Island. Score now 11-3 to 2-4. 69-16. Work that out for yourself, folks. Ball kicked in play by McKellar. Atkinson punches the ball down to who? Gisbert's over the top. Good vision. Cleary. Smothered. Picked up by Lovett. Lovett on the left foot. Along the boundary line finds Burton. Burton's marked the ball. He's got some possessions, Burton. It's a lovely disposal of the ball, and he kicks it across to McKellar. McKellar's got the ball. Transverses play right across the ground to It's Chris Ross. He's got a mile of room, but he overruns the ball. He's nearly caught. He just breaks the tackle in time. Clears the balls to nobody in particular, except it's back to Big Gilly. Gilly with the right foot drives the ball into full forward and marked again by Hooper. Hooper is keeping Rovers in the game, Darryl. He is keeping him in the game. He has taken everything that's come down his way. He lines them up.
Laurie and Paulie having a little scruffy.
And he misses. Laurie Howe and Justin Paul. Well, Justin's only had one kick so far, so he wouldn't be happy. But then again, the ball hasn't been delivered too good down there, so you can't really blame him for that. Bad miss by Tim Hooper. They needed that, Rovers. They really needed it. Laurie Howe comes in. Brings the ball back into play. Oh, Gisbert's going up. He's showing his class, Gisbert's, today. He really is. Left foot looking for Johnny Evans. Misses it. Matty Cowburn taps it over the top. Patching's all by himself if he wants it. The ball bounces nice. Cowburn tries a shepherd. Little kick along. Ross in front of Duggan. He's got the ball. He's still trying. He gets rid of it. Quick handball out to... who's that? Julian Wintle. Julian Wintle on the left foot. Drives it long. Centre of the ground. High flyers required. Grace after the ball. He's moving very gingerly, Grace. Up against Jarvis Weston, looking for the free kick. Justin Paul caught. He's held. Didn't have the ball. And the umpire's going to give him a free kick. Well, you can count this as a goal because this bloke don't miss him. He don't know how to miss goals, this fella. Second possession. Can he bring up Rovers' third goal? League best and fairest winner this year. The rest of his teammates will be hoping he pops this one through. They need this goal desperately, Rovers. Lines them up. Follows through. Straight through the high diddle. The umpire didn't even move. Goal of Rovers. Their third goal for the game, brought up by Justin Paul. They need him to fire. They need a few more of the other players to fire. 3-5 now, Rovers. 23, Phillip Barlin, 11 goals, 369. Difference of 46 points. The ball back in the centre now with the umpire. Pardinelli bounces the ball, shocking bounce. Danny Williams half taps it down to Gisbert's. Kick up in the air, not 10. Ball smothered. Burton's trying to break through the pack, and the umpire rightly called him for holding the ball. He was just trying to do that little bit too much. So young Jones, he's got it. Goes along the wing, and he finds Ian Ricks. Ian Ricks with the ball, in front of Tassari. He's been called across the ground in the play. Duggan gets the ball, handballs back to Matty Cowboy. Matty Cowboy back to Patching. Patching, a quick kick up towards Pete Cleary, who used his body belt. Well, Niven off the ground. Young Ross got caught beautifully too. Niven's in there. Oh, the tackling is fierce. Fernanda, he gets up out of nowhere. He runs around them all. Lines up the goals and says, thank you very much. How are they going to stop this bloke? He's on fire, Fernanda. He went one way, came back the other, broke a tackle and spun around and kicked the goal. That's enough to break your heart. That was a great inspirational goal by Peter Fernanda. And I'll tell you what, I don't know whether Rovers can find someone to stop that bloke. The Gippsland Building Approval scoreboard now goes Phillip Island, 12 goals 3, Rovers 3 goals 5. Yeah, ball bounced. No one gets the ball. Scrum develops in the middle. Number 14 is Rod Tack. He gets a quick kick out. Gisbert's again. And it's marked by, Glenn Burt. Glenn changes the play. Oh, the ball bounced for Phillip Island. Everything's going Phillip Island's way. Taken by Shannon Logan. Long kick up the Duggan. And he's against Ross. Oh, Duggan reads a play. Tries to get a handball. Well done, young Ross. Battled hard. Taps the ball back to McKellar. McKellar, a little tap along to Danny Williams. Danny Williams, a handball over to Evans. Johnny Evans, a short pass, and he's found Duggan again. He'll kick a goal from here. He's only 40 metres out. And Glenn Burt trying to give him a bit of a hard time there, but I think he was just playing around. Duggan was looking for an extra 50 metres, I think. Anyway, Duggan's been dangerous on that half-forward line. He's lining up the ball. Straight in front, 40 metres. Out. Kicks the ball low and to the right. He kicked very close to the man on the mark there. So 12 goals, 4 and out of 3 goals, 5. It's almost 9 goals, 53 points the difference. And Phillip Boland is certainly setting him up with a very good lead. I don't think they could have dreamt of a better start than this. McKellar kicks out right down the centre, patching everyone, missed, went over the back. Burton, behind the pack, read the play, kicks it long towards the Grace direction, punched away by Weston, great defence. But I think he's going to pay the free kick to Grace for too high, is he? What's he doing? He's going back that way. No, it's a free kick's going to Jarvis Weston. I never saw what that was for, but he deserved it just because of his defensive play. Weston. A bit sore on the leg there. One kick at McKellar looking for a free kick. It was Atkinson to tack. Taken by Lovett on the left foot. In the centre half forward. Ricks pushes the ball down in front. An attempt to kick the ball. Taken by Logan. Handball to someone running past. Back to Logan. Jones did it beautifully there. Just to Cleary. Cleary got in front of his man. Niven had the ball smothered away. Lindsay. Handball out now to tack. Oh, Glenn Bird it is, yeah. Right foot kick right down into the goal square now. Can someone mark it? Yes. Beautiful mark there. Beautiful mark taken by Tack. That's right. White legs like Justin Paula. For a minute I thought it was him. Rod Tack having a shot for goal 15 metres out. Started his career with Rovers with Glen Alvey thirds. Has a shot for goal, hooks it around, but I think it's enough to get it through. Yes, it's a goal of the Rovers, kicked by Rod Tack. They now go on to 4 goals, 5. Phillip Island, 12 goals, 4. So it's goal for goal now in this quarter. Goal for goal. Phillip Island still holding a 48-point lead. So this quarter's gone around about 15 minutes, Darryl.
You're very right, Tony. Paul shifted out to centre-half forward.
All right, Justin Paul, yeah, tacked the full forward, Paul of centre-half. Lovett gets the ball out of the centre. Burton, great effort to mark the ball, missed it. McKellar's in there, burrowing, gets a handball out to Grace. Grace will lift a handball across to Burton. Big left foot kick. The ball punched through for a behind. Rush for a behind. Rovers are certainly looking a little bit better now. They've improved their play. They're getting the ball out of the centre, Darryl, which has made the difference. Laurie Howe looks as though he's in a bit of trouble or something wrong with his boot or something. The ball's been called back by the umpire. Been kicked in by Brad Walker. Brad Walker sees Laurie Howe, and he's going to go for him. Laurie sets himself, taken by Bradley, handball to no one in particular. Piera gets this little short kick in and finds his captain in Danny Williams, who plays on. McKellar got beautifully tackled then, fights for the ball again, and the umpire says, I'll have the ball, thank you. There's a Rovers player that's down, and he's not moving very well. I didn't see what happened then, it would have been fair anyway. Who is it?
What?
Oh, someone would appear to be maybe winded or knocked to the head. Young Ross Lovett, is it? He's not too well. He's moving around now. It's just been good, hard and fair play in there today. I think they're going to bring him off the ground and give him a rest. He's not moving too well. Ball's been bounced. Bradley's chasing the ball. Danny Williams now in front of it. He'll probably run it out of bounds. No. Tied up in the forward pocket, and no one can get it out. The umpire says, thank you very much, I'll have it. And he's going to ball it up in the forward pocket. At 15 minutes into the quarter, Phillip Island and Rovers have gone goal for goal this quarter. Big knock by Patching. Kept in play by McKellar. Slipped around on his right foot. Oh, good tackle against Brad Walker there. Plenty of weight being used. The umpire says he's going to bounce it again. Bounce up in the forward pocket. Rovers deep in attack. Bounce of the ball. No one got it really. Jonesy gets a handball out to Keenan McIntosh. Thought the Rovers players was held. Len should have been a free kick, but the umpires called play on. It's been chased by Burt across to Tassari. Short pass to Grace on his own. And Grace should have a shot for goal from that position. Just a bit of loose checking by the Island. The Rovers are certainly showing a little bit more this quarter. Dr. Grace comes in, shoots for goal, and says, I'll have a goal, thank you. Right through the middle. So Rovers starting to bridge the gap a bit now. They've kicked their fifth major. They're still seven goals behind the Island, but seven goals was certainly better than nine, what it was a few minutes ago. So they're coming back with a bit of vengeance, Rovers. A couple more before half-time, and they're in with a sniff, Darryl. By a bounce, about to bounce the ball. Yeah, nice bounce. Patching springs, doesn't do any good with it. Burton runs through. Gilliland gets a handball out to McKellar. McKellar ducks and weaves. Gets around, nice shepherd by Gilliland. Little kick into Matt Chisholm. Matt Chisholm left foot, looking for Grace. Jarvis Weston in front. Taken by Sturton. Across to... I missed that. Wintle, was it? Mark Bradley has a shot in the left with his left foot and puts it through for a point. It was a very nice shot by Mark Bradley. Rovers doing all the attacking, no doubt about that. They're getting it out of the centre. They've got a few blokes decided to want to have a bit of a go now. So the score is Rovers 5 goals 8, I believe. 5 goals 7, Phillip Island 12 goals 4. Ball kicked in play, taken by Danny Williams. He's going to take a long kick into full forward. No mark taken by Niven. Caught by White Court. Danny Williams is all clear. A little pass. The lead's been made by Cleary and he's got it. He's got it. 40 metres out. Kicking into a bit of a breeze. I don't know whether he can make the distance from there, Clears. He goes for the pass. No, he's found Duggan. Well, this is going to be a difficult shot, but a little pass to Fernandez, everyone missed everything there. Fernandez trying to break through the pack and the umpire's going to have it. Well, comedy of errors there. His pass was just a little bit too high. He was by himself. It was the way to go. Player bounces the ball in the goal square for Phillip Island. Is it going to be rushed through? Yes, it is. Rushed through for one behind on the Gippsland Building Approval scoreboard now. Phillip Island, 12 goals 5, Rovers 5 goals 7. Ball to be kicked in by Sean Sturton, son of the president of the Rovers Footy Club, goes to the half-back flank to the lead by Fisher, and Fisher takes the mark. Steve Fisher kicks the ball to Johnny Evans, who can't take the mark. Bradley's looking to do something. Punched on by Ricks, a good punch. Gisbert's never had the ball. The advantage not paid. My God, if it had been, it was all over for another goal. He had the ball and dropped it a bit, Darryl, a little bit touchy, but anyway, it looked so much more that he was trying to make the play and was restricted in moving the ball. So, it's not Gisbert's, it's Cleary. God, he looked like Gisbert's for a minute then, the way he moved. Cleary comes in for shoot for goal. Looking all right. If it's got the carry, it is. Has it or not? No, one behind. 12 goals, 6, Phillip Island. Rovers, 5 goals, 7. It's done. 41 points of difference. The ball kicked out to Wintle. Wintle, the left foot, beautiful left foot, kicked down the wing side, and it's marked by Tassari. Tassari with the ball. Centre wing, kicks the ball right down into the wing attack, but there again is that Cleary again, like he's been everywhere. Just had a shot for goal a minute ago. Sees the lead, Danny Williams all by himself in the centre. Kicks the ball, looking for David Niven. Atkinson had to punch the ball, he had no option. Jones is down in front, can he pick up the ball? No, it's Sean Sturton tripped, I thought. Oh, holding the ball, the umpire couldn't see it was behind the play. And he says, now I better have the ball. The umpire certainly missed that. He was behind the play, but it was a free kick, in my opinion, of the Rovers fella. Umpire bounces the ball, centre wing. Bradley gets the ball down. Jones breaks through the pack on his left foot. Gilliland all by himself takes the mark. Young Simon Gilliland. Free kick paid. On his right foot, kicks a big drop punt. Ah, forward line, oh, nearly a mark to Rovers. Yes, it's been paid. It's been paid to Bradley, has it? Yes, it has. Young Mark Bradley, inclusion into the side. Short pass, looking for Justin Paul. Laurie Howe spoils, Ricks takes the ball, keeps it out in front of him, running player in patching court, gets a handball over to Piera. Playing a great game, kicks the ball to the wing, looking for Niven, and Niven takes a wonderful mark. Out in front of Mackey. He's going to give him 50. I think he blew the whistle 3 times. He said, come back here with me, mate. I'm going to give you 50 metres. They're just saying, who's the boss around here? The Island can turn this right into attack now. Niven with the ball, right on the 50-metre line. He's going to kick from 55. Kicks it up to Scotty Hugh, the very poor kick. And the ball's taken by Fisher. Fisher kicks it to Atkinson too high. Oh, well, he took the mark and everything in front of Jonesy. Good mark, Aki. Kicks the ball down to the wing. Looking for Patching and Bradley. No one's got it. Ricks gets the ball. Oh, two Island players run into each other. Taken by Sturton. A quick handball across to Burton. Burton on the left foot across the centre forward. Justin Paul with Laurie Howering in pursuit. Paul's got the front running here. He's going to run into an open goal here. He has a shot and he doesn't make any mistakes, this bloke. He put it straight through the high diddle. That was very, very good play. So Justin Paul brings up his second and Rovers just bridged that gap that little bit more. 12 goals, 6 to 6 goals, 7. There's only 6 goals in it. There's nothing in this game again. They're bridging the gap. David Niven's coming off. And move's been made. The old whale comes on. Ball bounce. Taken by Tim Hooper. Big left foot kick in the centre forward. Ball punched down. It's all Rovers at the moment. Danny Williams paddles it out from underneath. Ricks misses the mark. The old whale uses his body. Gets a handball up to Ricks. Gets a, he was tackled last minute. Lindsay, good use of the ball. Taken by Jones, the ball has been smothered. Rixie's there. And the ball is taken out of bounds. Out of bounds in front of the members, as you can hear everyone, all the supporters screaming at the umpire and going crook at the players. All believe it's their free kick. The umpire's going to throw it in. Throwing in centre wing. Patching and Gilliland. Patching gets a knock. Evans with strength. Busts through the packs. Ex-Sydney Swans player. Kicks the ball up the forward line and it's out of bounds. Actually, Johnny Evans got wearing Swans shorts. He's got the blue stripe down the side. He might get fined, Darryl. The umpire throws it in. Throws in our forward line. Johnny Evans gets the ball down. Taken to McKellar. McKellar across to Wintle. Wintle across to Atkinson. Atkinson doesn't know what to do. Gets the ball on the right foot and he finds Gilland. It was a good move. Is he going to... Yes, he handballs it on. Handballs it on to Chris White. White across to... Oh, leg. No, he never paid the free kick. Umpire, what a mistake. Even I have to agree with that. Got him too low. Sean Sturton can't believe it. Ball is bounced. God, he did it right in front of the Rovers' rooms too. Yeah, big. There had to be a Phillip Island free kick. Little bit of frustration there. And I'll tell you what, the little book's coming out here. Yellow card. Hooper's been booked for telling the umpire that he's a silly old sausage. He's off for 15 minutes. He's a prime mover. He can't play for 15 minutes. Darryl, is that right?
That's correct.
Yeah, so...
They,
you know, he's one of their best players. Patching takes the ball, plays on. Oh, yes, pushed out by Cleary, free kick to Rovers. Bronx cheers and the ball's taken by McKellar. McKellar on the twin half-back and wing for Rovers. On the right foot, plays on. Looking for Justin Paul, one hand only, not good enough. Laurie Howes hasn't got the ball, should have been a free kick, not paid, never mind. Out to Gisbert's. Gisbert's had to lose all by himself, chose to go the other way, dug and missed it. Widened Nathan and Boo Piera. Piera, no, the umpire's going to call for the ball. There's a bit of pressure out there. Umpire bounces the ball. Beautiful bounce. Good knock by Bradley. Down to no one in particular. Whale, too high against the Rovers free kick. Tackle too high. McKellar's free kick. He wants to handball it, but here he is. He's going to give a little short pass across here to nearly never come off. Who's that, Darryl? Jai Hart. The siren goes for half-time. The half-time scores on the Gippsland Building Approval scoreboard. Phillip Island, 12 goals, 6. Rovers, 6 goals, 7. That's a lead of 35 points to Phillip Island. Rovers pegged them back a goal that quarter. It's still reachable, in my opinion. Darryl, what do you think? It's only 6 goals. Surely you'd like to make some comments on what do you think of Rovers' chances now at half-time?
Rovers have improved, but at the moment you'd say they're only being competitive. They've got to look after Fernanda. Fernanda's, he's just dominating, isn't he? When he comes onside, he's dominating. But the Rovers, 6 goals down, something similar last year, Tony.
Was it about six goals last year?
6 goals down last year, and the Rovers were very confident last year at half-time. Yeah. I wouldn't be as confident this year, but I think...
The Island have certainly played the much better football for this part of the game, haven't they, really, for this first half?
For sure, Tony.
They deserve to be in front, don't you agree?
Yes. Then again, has the Island got a problem with coming back? A couple of weeks ago, Tony, what happened with Darlston? They were 7 goals up.
Yeah.
So...
Yeah. But then again, last week against Darlston Rovers, Darlston had 15 men on the ground at one stage, and that Rovers were 7 goals in front, and Darlston pegged them back to 4, so I suppose... If you want to make comparisons, anything can happen.
Anything can happen in football.
That's right. Okay, well, look, we'll have a break at half-time. I want to give my voice a rest, and you go and see what Rovers' rooms have to say, and I'll go and see what Phillip Island has to say. Okay, Darryl, we'll see you later. Thank you. Okay, well, we're back. Back now after half time. One half of football to go. I'll just go over the scores again. Phillip Island, 12 goals, 6. Rovers, 6 goals, 7. 35 points of difference. And Phillip Island kicking with the aid of a breeze this quarter. I went into the club rooms at half time, and Darryl's gone in to listen to what the Rovers coach had to say. They were reminded of last year's loss. They had the video of last year's loss when that siren went to remind them of the disappointment of losing a premiership. And I'm sure they don't want to don't want that to happen again. They know what they've got to do. They relaxed a little bit in that quarter. This is a premiership quarter. They need to get a few. The coach said that he wanted to get a few more goals on the board. We can get up an extra four goals this quarter with the wind advantage. That means that Rovers are going to have to kick around about 10 in the last quarter. But he asked for a commitment from everyone to run and to chase, for the forward line to work a lot harder than what they did in that quarter, and go on with the job. Darryl, what did Greg have to say to his players?
They're still confident they can come back, Tony. The boys have to lift their workload. As he said, they've nullified them in that quarter, pegged them back by two goals. The game is not over yet, and if the boys have Phillip Island just jumped them in the first quarter, and again in the start of the second quarter, and if they can just continue to turn the game around and deliver the ball better down the forward line, they've got a chance.
Fair enough.
But you'd have to give credit to Phillip Island. They've produced the goods. Just talking to the guys here doing the taping, they've just played it back and they said they can't believe the speed of the game. You think it was on fast forward.
There
you go. Gives you an indication.
Well, it's been a great game. The best two teams are playing it off today. And you know, I think we're in for a crackerjack second half. Fitness is going to play a great bearing on this game. Darryl, if your blokes come up out of the... Let's face it, Phillip Island reserves and thirds had to play the preliminary. They've both come up and won. You blokes had a hard game last week and you're now playing Phillip Island, who had a rest. Anyway, it's been a great game. We look forward to a good second half, eh?
Thank you.
Okay, thanks, Darryl. Umpires in readiness now to commence proceedings for the second half. Bass Valley Grand Final, Phillip Island versus Wonthaggi Rovers. Pied and Ely to bounce the ball. In the ruck, patching. In the ruck for Rovers, Bradley. Taken by Bradley, tapped down to McKellar. Cross to Burton on the right foot. Grace. Up near Grace. Weston tries to punch it away, taken by Hauer. Laurie gets his kick. Straight across the goal is taken by, who's that, Tack, is it?
Burt,
kicking the foot. Forward line and a beautiful mark taken by Shannon Logan. Last line of defence. Shannon Logan gets a nice pass to Danny Williams and Danny takes an easy mark. Danny kicks the ball across to the wing. Evans thought got one high, not paid. The ball trapped in there, handball's coming out. Cowburn throws himself in at the ball and the umpire says, "I'll have it, thank you," and he's going to ball it up. Evans come out of that one with a very bad limp. Taken by Patching, knocked down. McKellar held without the ball and it's his free kick. McKellar started to come into the game halfway through that second quarter and he's already started to be ominous now in this quarter. He's had a couple of possessions already. Kicks the ball deep into the forward pocket for Rovers. High flyers wanted the ball, knocked down. Ball kicked out, taken by Patching, who knocks it along, and the ball is still in play. I thought it was out of play for a minute. Oh, player nearly caught one in the back there, taken by Jarvis Weston, clears the ball and finds Peter Cleary. Peter Cleary with the ball in the centre wing on the outer side, brings the ball into the centre of the ground. Duggan nearly takes, the umpire called play and I thought it was a mark. Gisbert's tried to tap it on. Burton stayed under, trapped the ball, got a good handball out to Sturton, across to Atkinson. Atkinson, loose man to Julian Wintle. He's on the left foot, looking for Justin Paul. He's found him. Oh. No, he hasn't. He's missed it, but he'll snap it on his left foot. Yes, it's a goal. A great goal by Justin Paul. And that's just the start that Wonthaggi Rovers wanted. Great play emanating from Burton that time and Sturton in that across the half back line, Darryl.
Yes.
Very good football. So that brings them a goal closer. Scores are Phillip Island 12 goals 6, Rovers 7 goals 7. Contact. 29 points a difference. Pine to bounce the ball. In the ruck, Bradley for Rovers, and in the ruck is Patching for Phillip Island. Patching gets it down, Danny Williams a handball over, Everyone's trying to tap the ball over the top. No one clear. Bradley gets a handball out. Very good play to Tassari on the left foot. Looking for Gilliland, who'd lost the ball. Danny Williams is caught with the ball, holding the ball. Play on call. Advantage played to McKellar. McKellar gets a handball across to Jai Hart. Jai Hart on the right foot sees a man, Julian Wendell, all by himself. He was instrumental in getting the ball up there for the last goal. Man, Tassari all by himself. Takes the ball, plays on, runs down a centre forward, kicks it up towards Tack. Ricks gets one high, recovers beautifully, kicks the ball, centre wing, looking for Duggan. Duggan in close pursuit to Burt, hasn't got the ball. Burton now, first in for the ball, ducks around Jones and delivers the ball beautifully to Tassari. Tassari's got the ball. The centre of the ground. Rovers certainly playing more inspired football this quarter. He kicks the ball up towards... Justin Logan nearly took the mark. He came down pretty hard. Ricks taps it on. Danny Williams gets it out to Cowburn. Cowburn breaks clear, kicks it down the centre wing. Young... Piera, great mark. Great mark by Boo Piera. Transfers the play, the call of Laurie Howe. Oh, Laurie Howe got pinged from in front. No free kick given. Cleary in the back of Lindsay. Lindsay gets the ball over to McKellar. McKellar and Danny Williams chase for the ball. Williams, sheer guts and determination, gets it out to McIntosh. That was great play by the captain coach. Under great pressure, gets the ball to Duggan. Duggan's mucking around with it, taking his time. A shocking pass. Beats everyone across to Bradley. Bradley on the left foot, the centre of the ground. No one takes it clear. Fernanda ducks around, gets a handball out. Not clear handball to Gisbert's. Gisbert's trying to do something with it. Hasn't got the ball, and it's got to be his free kick. Free kick to Rod Gisbert's. Goes for the top, looking for distance. Down to Scotty Huth, has been shut right out of it since then. Curl marks. Can he do something? No, he's right over the Rovers' back, and it'll be a free kick to Wonthaggi Rovers to be taken by young Mark Bradley. Bradley, last line of defence. We had to kick the ball out. Kicks it in the direction of Fisher and Burton again. Had a lot of possessions, Burton. Jones gets the handball out. Phillip on a bloke, ducked his head. Jones went for the handball, that was smothered. Tries it again, looking for someone to give it to. And it's been overrun by Danny, who's still battling on. Cleary never had the ball. Been rushed up there, and Julian Wendell had a go at getting the ball. Gilliland sees the ball clearly and passes beautifully to Sturton. No, it's not, it's Chris White. Chris White with the ball half back line, looking for the short pass, quite an ordinary pass, and it's, I'd say, out of bounds. Yes, out of bounds. Centre wing for on the members' side. Marks, Bradley for the ruck. Bradley gets the ball. Ducked his head, Laurie Howe. Lucky to get a free kick there. I felt as though he ducked his head. No one's giving him anything from the forward line. They're not moving. He's having to kick it long and hope for the best. And Cleary comes in and takes the mark. Cleary's looking for a lead. He's looking for Niven. Well punched away by Atkinson. That was good football, good defence. Cowburn's there. Sturton gets the ball to Lovett. Lovett gets the ball back to Atkinson, who followed up. Gets the ball to Grace. Oh, bad bounce. It was bad luck for Grace. But, well, gone through there by, who was that? Jai Hart. Young kid, plenty of pace. The ball out. Free kick going to Phillip Island. I don't know what for, but anyway, it's been played to the island. Well, Rovers are certainly looking a different team now, Darryl. They're certainly coming back. Short pass into Cowburn. And Matty Cowburn's marked the ball, centre wing of the ground, the outer side. Very little movement in the Phillip Island forward line. Ball punched by Lindsay, out in front of McKellar. McKellar's caught, thought it was too high, and McKellar gets a free kick. He was a little bit lucky, but he still got the free kick. McKellar with the ball. 29 points, still the difference. He's taking his time. He's looking for a lead. He's got Paul going for a lead. Shannon Logan out in front. Jonesy takes the ball very easy and finds Fernando. Over the top he'll go to Cleary. He should. He doesn't. He plays on now. Pass. Oh, pass is taken by Sturton. The pass was a bit too long. Up in the air, patching flies. No one takes the mark. Grace is there. Gets a handball out to Tassari. Back to Grace. Tassari, free kick. Too high. The Rovers are certainly showing a lot of desperation out there at the moment. Tassari, handball out to Mark Bradley. Big loping left foot kick. Paul, free kick. Definitely pushed out. Had to be. Had to be a free kick. And Justin Paul will take a kick from about 35 metres. He doesn't miss these goals. Now you can just about write this one down in the book. What do you think, Darryl?
Things are looking better for Rovers. Yeah. Not that I'm being biased, yeah. Tony.
No, they are. They're playing certainly better. There's no doubt about that. They're showing more desperation. The Phillip Island forward lines has been shut down. Fernanda's been made quiet. And Rovers forward line's doing something. They're moving a lot. And let's face it, they've only got 17 men. Tim Hooper's not back yet.
Another 5 minutes from Hooper will be back on. Mm. And after this one, maybe four goals, they're in with a chance.
Yes, yeah. Justin Paul lines them up. Kicks offline, it would appear. It is offline. Yes. Now, that's not really like Justin to do that. That's the Phillip Island's favour. So the points, the difference is 28 points, 12, 6 to 7, 8. The ball's kicked. The ball punched to the boundary line and it's going to go out of bounds.
It's a bad mistake by Jay, missing that.
Yes, I think you needed that goal. Could have made a big difference. Ball thrown in. Gilliland held with the ball. Burton's managed to get lots of kicks today. Shannon Logan, a beautiful mark. He's got a bit of class, this kid. Tassari's looking for an Oscar award. Jones is free. Oh, he didn't pay it. I thought he should have paid that. Oh, Cleary with utter strength. Just belted his way through that. He's played a great game, Cleary, Darryl. And the ball is still in play. It's out of play now. Taken by Burt. Glenn Burt, I think that is. That wind's coming up. I'll tell you what. The Island need to get a couple of goals here. If they want to feel safe about getting into a getting a premiership. Ball punched out. Beautiful tackle in a Ricks. Tackle against on the Rovers play and the umpires decided to ball it up. Ball up, centre wing, member side. Just a touch in Phillip Island's offensive. Oh, bounces the ball. Bradley and everyone misses it. And I think the ball's going to get rushed out of bounds. No, it's been bottled up again. The umpire's going to have to bounce it. Umpire to bounce the ball. Between centre wing and half forward flank for Phillip Island. Bradley gets a tap out, gets a second tap. Cowburn tacked the ball, missed it. Taken by Tack, I think it was. This bloke's played a corker, this Burton. Left foot kick up to Jai Hart, who takes the mark. Champion player, Jai Hart. Across to Sturton. They're full of running Rovers at the moment. Kicks the ball at Brad Walker, nearly took the mark. Danny Williams, snark by Paul. Open goal, thank you very much. That's good football by Rovers. They're right in this game, Rovers now. They're right in it, Darryl. There's no doubt about that. As a guy said, it's not over to the fat lady sings, and they're right back in this game. They're right back in the game. Couple of fun.
No.
Back with the umpire in the centre. Rovers have done all the scoring this quarter, into the wind too. Bradley gets a knockout. Sturt never had the ball, free kick. A few silly mistakes being made up by Phillip Island now. Sturton's lifted him this quarter. and he's found Tassari. Tassari's been a bit dangerous this quarter too. Short pass, and he's found McKellar. McKellar, long kick, Justin Paul territory. Oh. Laurie Howe nearly took the mark. The ball's been bottled up there in the right in the goal line, and the umpire's called for a bounce. Well, it's been a long time since I've seen the ball on Phillip Island's forward line. There's just been no system there whatsoever. The scores are 8-8. Rovers, Island 12-6. There's only 4 goals in this game. A little kick out to Sturton again. He seems to be where the ball is all the time. To Tassari, left foot snap for goal. What has he done? One behind. Tell you what, that would have been a handy one, Darryl. 8-9-12-6 now. Laurie Howe to kick the ball back into play. The Island system seems to have gone. He's gone for the Torp, and not a bad one either. Punch down in front. Fernanda misses the ball. Bradley misses the ball. Ack gets a Sturton again. Has a shot for goal. It comes up to Justin Paul. Taking the mark. He's in front. It was a bit of a missed kick by Sturton, but it's finished up being in the right spot because it's gone straight into Justin Paul's hands. He's not going to miss this one, Darryl.
We certainly hope not.
Well, the Island have got the job in front of them now. It's definitely the scoring end, the bottom end.
A lot more pressure coming from the Rovers.
Yes, they're running more. The Island seem to have stopped. He comes in. Great deliberation. And sticks it right through the middle. Goal of Rovers. It's back down to 16 points of difference now. They've pegged it back. They've pegged it right back on the Gippsland Building Approval Scoreboard. It's Phillip Island 12-6. They've been stagnant on that for a while. Rovers 9-9. 15 points the difference here at the Wonthaggi Oval. There's only 3 kicks in it now. Beautiful sunshine on the ground. From being a whitewash, the game certainly changed now. It looked like a whitewash, Darryl. Bayer bounces the ball. Nullified at centre bounce. Gisbert tries to go through, belts it on. No one in particular. All the ball's running Rovers' way now. McKellar gets another possession for the quarter. Kicks it up near Jai Hart. Jarvis Weston gets it. The ball's out of bounds. They're calling for deliberately out of bounds. I can't see how they saw that. Bayer throws the ball in. Simon Gilland grabs the ball, taken by Fernanda. Trips over. McKellar's got the ball. Holding the ball. No, he's going to ball it up. He's going to ball it up. McKellar got the knockout. Oh, he was held on for too long. Stupid. McKellar centres the ball across the centre forward. Danny Williams knocked off balance. Tassari uses his brain, taps it on. Hooper's back on the ground. Has his kick smothered, but back to Tassari. Can he get it this time? No. McIntosh is there for the ball. The umpire's going to have a ball up. Umpire's going to ball it up. It's all been Rovers this quarter. Danny Williams has got a bit of the cramp. I know he's got a sore ankle. Patching. Nothing. Gilland gets it out. Sturton, quick kick in a full forward. Straight to Laurie Howe. And Laurie Howe takes the mark, last line of defence. I'm going to start to make some moves, Phillip Island. They've just gone right off the boil. Laurie drives the ball. Not taken. McKellar. Short to Grace. And Grace has taken a mark. He can ping it right up here.
Danny's all tied up.
And Danny Williams is down at the moment. He's cramping pretty badly. Grace, nice looking kick for goal. One behind. The difference now is 14 points, 12-6 to 9-10. 19 scoring shots to 18. So Rovers have now had more scoring shots in the island. And who would have thought that with 10 goals to 2 at one stage? Laurie Howe going for the Torp. He's got on it. He's kicked that 75 metres. That's a magnificent kick. No mark. But Rovers are down. Reading Jai Hart swings the ball around his body. Almost a mark to Phillip on the attack. Keenan gets in it. McIntosh. Patching. Long kick. Marked by Duggan. The ball's finally down to Phillip Island's forward line. Marked by Niven. Niven's taken the mark. He needs to shoot this goal desperately. David Niven. Back on the ground. Having a shot for a goal 40 metres out. Up in the air, it's not going to make the distance. Or is it? Touched off the hands of the players. So 1 point to the island. That's their first score for the quarter. The island now go to 12-7, Rovers 9-10. 15 points of difference, 15 minutes into the third quarter. 19 minutes into the third quarter. It's been a great quarter for Rovers, this. The ball is with the fullback.
No, Sturton.
Sturton, who kicks off the side of his boot, out on the full. And the kick to be taken by David Jones. It was rather sloppy by Sean. Short pass, didn't come off. Gisbert's missed it, went up one hand. Ball smothered to boot McKellar again. McKellar's been everything this quarter. He's done some marvellous things. Sturton gets a handball quick to Burton. He got a heavy knock. Sturton. Beautiful use of the body by Burt. Burt running it down the boundary line, kicks the ball in the centre forward. Justin Poore nearly takes a mark to Sari. Quick handball over to Grace. Grace running after the ball. He's been held. And it's a free kick to Grace in front of goal. This is going to bring the difference if he gets this back to 9 points. We have got a ball game on our hands here. I think Gracie was that slow, he got a shock. He makes no mistake with it, it's a goal. And Rovers now only 9 points down. 10 goals, 10 to 12 goals, 7. Phillip Island have had a bit of a sleep this quarter. It's exactly what their coach didn't want them to do. Been very fair commentary for both teams.
I can't dispute that, can I, Tony?
Who's that idiot up there? That bloke up the back, at the back there.
That's on job.
He's an idiot. Bayer bounces the ball. Patching gets it to Gisbert's. Gisbert's quick kick around the corner. Wilder loses on. They're going for a bit of experience now, the island. White can't get the ball. He's a young kid there. DeLuce is trying to get the ball out. It's been bottled up and bottled up on Phillip Island's half forward line.
He's still a very valuable player at his age, isn't he, Tony?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, using him in spurts, he might be able to create something. But here's McKellar again. McKellar's had a million possessions this quarter. A million possessions.
Well, they say you can't keep a good man down.
Yeah, that's right. Certainly can. Matty Cowburn, there's battling for the ball. The umpire's going to ball it up. Well, the Island are going to have to pull something out of the fire here. They've gone backwards since the 20-minute mark of the second quarter. They've got that desire, they can do it. If they haven't, well, Rovers are going to do it. Hooper gets the ball out to Sturton. Sturton gets a short pass to McKellar again. He's everywhere. McKellar on it to Sari, who slipped over at the last minute, holding the ball. Good decision by the umpire. And the free kick goes to, who is it, Logan. He looked Brad Walker's by himself and he decided to play along the wing. Matt Cowburn misses the mark, taken by Piera. Long kick across to Gisbert's and Gisbert's by himself takes the mark. Gisbert's now with an open forward line, kicks the ball. Yeah. Niven takes the mark. No, he called play on the umpire. No, he's paid the mark. He's paid the mark to Niven for too high. Was it the mark of the free kick, Darryl?
Too high.
Too high. David Niven. Phillip Island really need this goal, I can tell you. They haven't scored one major this quarter. Niven walks in, shoots for goal and puts it through. They needed that one, the Island. 13 goals, 7 now to 10 goals, 10. It's 15 points the difference. Nothing in this game. Nothing in this game at all. Well, it's turned out a beautiful day today. Blue skies, ground's in excellent condition. There's no reason why good football can't be played. I tell you what, we haven't seen much of Peter Fernando this quarter, Darryl. He's made the difference. He's been extremely quiet. He's got that young Julian Wintle on him at the moment. He has shut him out of the game a bit, actually. Taken by Brad Walker on the right foot, across the ground. Should remain in play. Who's chasing it there? Burt.
Shepherd by Hooper.
Hooper.
Onto Hooper.
Onto Hooper.
Back to Burt.
Back to Burt. Lost the ball. Phillip Island player in. Back to White. Gets a handball out, and I think might meet them all over and out of bounds. It certainly does. It's out of bounds. Centre wing position. 25 minutes into this quarter, I'd say, Darryl. And with the wind picking up, big chance now for Rovers to get right back in the game. They've done a marvellous job this quarter. Taken by the Island, and a good mark by Glenn Burt.
On to McKellar.
McKellar's making good position. He reads the play so well, this guy. Short pass now across to Burton. They've got a stack to run in now. They've got a stack to run in. He looks for Grace and found Grace. Grace with a handball back onto Burton. Burton's going to look for Justin Paul. He's made the right position. He takes the mark. You can see the setup there. You can see it all set up, Darryl. McKellar has played a fantastic quarter this quarter. He really has. He's got a heap of possessions. Gives it to Justin Paul, and Justin Paul now lining up from 20 metres out. Dead in front, straight through the high diddle. Goal of Rovers, back to 9 points of difference. They're finishing full of run. 25 minutes. Well, McKellar and Paul, this quarter have combined very well. McKellar getting lots of possession, Paul starting to kick a few goals. And they're right back in the game now, Rovers, in a big way.
Rovers' delivery down to the forward line.
Yeah, much better.
Much improved.
Yeah, much improved. They're running on. They're playing the possession game, and they're certainly doing the job. Fire bounces the ball. Patching gets the knockout. Young White, good play. He never had the ball. Cleary gets the free kick.
Still playing good.
It hasn't been a bad play today, Cleary. Looking for Niven. And I thought he got a bit of a push in the back, but he never tapped on to Carl Lindsay. Carl Lindsay gets a handball on to Wintle. Wintle on the right foot. Looking for Danny Williams over the back. Burton pressing his own player. Oh, I don't know where he got that free kick from. I thought it was his own player, Darryl. They didn't know whose it was even. That's how surprised they were. Taken by Julian Wintle. Nice kick up the half forward line. The ball's knocked out of bounds. Boundary umpire throws it in. Patching and Bradley. Patching gets the knockout. Patching gets the handball out, taps it on a bit further. Burton again. He's not letting go of the ball. He really wanted that ball. Cleary gets a quick kick. Niven gets pushed out of it. Lindsay gets a handball out. Cleary with a great
again.
Ball getting it out. Lindsay again thought he was caught a bit high. Yes, and he got the free kick. Certainly a bit of pressure on here now.
Decisions have started to go Rovers' way.
Yes, they have. They've turned it over, yes. Young Brett Lovett, Ross Lovett, kicks the ball beautifully to Timmy Hooper. Hooper on to Grace, he's made lovely position and Grace has marked it a centre-half forward.
With his hammies, he's still struggling to stick.
Yeah, well, I remember Campbell last year. He had crook hamstrings. I thought he was going to collapse any time. He just kept going the whole game, Darryl, and this bloke's done the same thing. Dr. Grace, shooting from 40 metres. It's a goal. It's a goal. No, it's not. It's a point. Bad luck. I thought the quietness of the Phillip Island crowd suggested that it might have been a goal.
I think Gracie thought so.
Goal, yeah. Goal. So it's 11-10, 11-11 to 13-7. There's only 8 points in this game. Laurie Hauer brings the ball back into play, kicks it straight to Tack. Rod Tack takes the mark.
On to Grace
on
again.
On to Grace again. He's going to get it. No. Laurie Howe's chasing it up. The ball could be out of bounds. Yes, it is. Out of bounds, forward pocket for Rovers. Rovers deep in attack. They've shell-shocked Phillip Island this quarter. They've just run harder, tackled harder, made position. A couple of their key players have got into the play. It's made all the difference. Ball punched on. David Jones gets a little handball out. Phillip Island player caught. McKellar has a quick snap. He hasn't, has he? No. And Laurie Hauer pushes it out of bounds. In the right forward pocket, right alongside the behind post. It's just been all Rovers the whole quarter. The whole quarter. There's the siren. Phillip Island will be happy to have a rest now. They're going to have to pull something out of the fire. The scores are 13-7 Phillip Island to Rovers 11-11. Rovers have pegged back. At one stage they were 9 goals down. They are now only 8 points down. So it's really anyone's game, and with Rovers kicking with a slight wind advantage, I'd like to think that they're a big chance. Darryl, what do you think, mate?
Well, Rovers were hoping to be within 3 goals at three-quarter time. They've done better than that. They've had a lot of scoring shots, which they've missed. I think they'll be running confident at this stage.
Yeah, well, it looks that way. They've certainly taken it up to Phillip Island, and the island players are starting to make a few mistakes. And it's just that Rovers have just pressured them so much, and they're certainly coming home with a wet sail. It's quite obvious, and I think Phillip Island's got the job in front of them. If they've got any character about them, they can fight back and show that they have been the top team all year and deserve to win the premiership. But the way it looks at the moment, Rovers are certainly putting a lot of pressure on, causing a lot of mistakes. The running players from Phillip Island aren't running like they were in the first quarter. And by gee, we're in for a great last quarter. 2 points last year it was, Darryl. God, I hope it doesn't happen like that again this year. But looks as though we're going to have to go through it. And well, I think it's going to be survival of the fittest. Things look better for Rovers, in my opinion, because of the way they played that quarter than what they do for Phillip Island. Let's see what Phillip Island can do.
It'll be a great last quarter, Tony.
Thanks, Darryl. Okay, we're in readiness now. The final quarter of a grand final is a bit of heavy stuff. Gunner Laurie Howard's trying to rough up a couple out there. And, well, it's going to be a close game, this one. 8 points of difference. Rovers coming home with a two-goal win advantage. So you'd have to think that they are favourites at this stage, the way they've been playing. I'll fix you up later. Dave, I'll fix you up in a minute for that, all right? Thanks. Umpire bounces the ball. Shocking bounce. Infringement. Free kick to Phillip Island. Patching gets the ball. Kicks it up to the half forward line. Taken casually by Rovers player. Kicks it at the half forward or wing line. Tassari's got the ball. Gets a handball across to Tack. No, Glenn Burke. Glenn Bird handballs back to Tassari, waits for it to come to him, gets a handball back to Glenn Bird again. He runs off, long kick in the centre-half forward. Patching, misses the mark, takes by Jai Hart, breaks away, shoots for goal and puts it straight through. There's 2 points in this game now. 2 points in the game. That is just the start that Rovers wanted.
Dave Wilson will get the
Well, Darryl, you said they like coming back. They've done it all the time, like unbelievable formula. It's not the way I like to play footy, but they are coming back, that's for sure. There's 2 points in it. The player bounces the ball. Big knock by Bradley. Young legs, big spring. Fernanda gets the ball. Brad Walker, quick left foot. Carl Lindsay reads the play. Patching misses a tap on. Taken by Sturton. Ducks and weaves. Gets it to Lovett. Lovett caught. Gets a handball out. Gets it again. Pushes it out to Lindsay. Lindsay out to Sturton again. Sturton caught with the ball. It's got to be holding the ball. Has to be. And the ball has been given up to Patching. Richard Patching. They need him to fire.
Hooper.
Smothers the ball from Jones. It was a bad pass. Has a bounce. Kicks the ball at Grace. Grace misses it. Fernanda tries to tap it back on. The ball's in a pack there. McKellar gets the ball out to Grace. No, the umpires decided to ball it up just when they were clear. Umpire bounces the ball. Bradley again gets a tap down straight to McKellar. Hit him right on the chest. Jarvis Weston pushes the ball along. Rovers fella tackled very hard, but the umpire said it was held to him. He said, give us the ball and I'll ball it up. Bio bounces the ball. Bradley again. Looking for the ball. Held to Patching and not Patching. Who was that? Ricks. Ian Ricks. Bio bounces the ball. Patching grabs it out of the ruck, gets a handball out to Fernanda. Pete's been very quiet. Last two quarters, they need him firing up, and he's put it out of bounds on the full. Not a good sign for Phillip Owen. They need Peter Fernanda firing. It's taken by Matt Chisholm. Matt Chisholm with the ball. Big kick in the centre-half forward. Patching takes the mark. Uses his kick to Duggan, and Duggan takes a nice mark in front of McKellar. Taking too long to get rid of the ball, the old, and they're standing still. Kicks to Cleary. Cleary couldn't get it. Oh, but managed to tap it on to Hooper. Gets a handball at Tassari. Tassari, a long handball of Burton. Burton with the left foot looking for Grace, and he's found him. Found him between half forward and the pocket. He could shoot for goal from there. He'd have the wins helping him there. Piss off. Grace lines him up. Shoots for goal. It's coming around. Enough? No. 1 point. Point the difference in this game. 13-7 to 12-12. 24 to 20 scoring shots. Who would have thought that at the end of quarter time? No, in their wildest dreams. Weston takes a short kick out to Deleuze. Deleuze plays on. Up to the wing. Oh, interference. Cleary's free kick. Cleary's played a very good game today for Phillip Olin. He's got a number of possessions. He's been called a play on. He has to get a hurry kick. Hurry kick to no one. Sturton. Handball out to White. White's still pushing the ball along. Oh, he's a great kid, this. On the left foot, looking for McKellar. Over his head. Red by Burton. Burton's a top player. He's had a bounce. Oh, nearly lost it. Just got tackled the last minute. And Brad Walker, second bite of the cherry, gets the mark. Gives it to Laurie Howe. Laurie Howe, a short pass, finds Patching. Patching now with the ball. He has a bounce. Shoots for Cleary. And finds him. It was a lovely pass. Cleary's been all over the ground. Cleary's asking him to move into the centre. He's had to go up the flank. And he slipped. They're not sure who to kick it to. Scott Huther hasn't had many touches since the first quarter. Sean, the mark is being taken by Patching. He was asked for a big effort by his coach. But oh, kick not the best. Curl marks caught. Lovett taps it along the ground. Two Phillip Island players run into each other. McKellar, short pass, looking for Dr. Grace and takes the mark. Just used his... he said he pushed him out. Well, I couldn't see that. I thought that was a bit harsh. Anyway, the free kick's been given to Jarvis Weston. Jarvis Weston kicks it along the flank. Patching was pushed out and definitely a free kick. The Island forward line is not running. They're hoping for miracles. Gisberts gets the ball down. The ball is out of bounds. McKellar there giving directions and telling his players to watch his man. Instead of calling for free kicks. Cleary, another kick. Huther running for the ball. Overruns it. And pushed out of bounds. Great defensive play by the Rovers backman there. Young, Steve Fisher. Done a good job on Huther since quarter time. Ball thrown back in. Curl Marks gets a knockdown. Snapped by, out of bounds on the full. Taken, who's got it, Darryl? Julian Wintle with the ball. Hugs the boundary line. Oh, lovely mark by Burton. He has played a top game, Burton. He's played an absolute ripper, this bloke. Not sure who to kick it to. On the left foot, a lovely left foot kick. Oh, Tax would have had that. Handball out by McIntosh to Whale. Whale gets a kick over to Cleary. Which way is the ball going to bounce? Has he got too much space for that? Whale gets it, handballs it, kicks it on now to Matty Cowburn. Oh, and he'll get 50 metres. No doubt about this. Come with me, the umpire will say. There you go, Darryl. It was on, wasn't it? It had to be. I picked it before he even did it. Bit of bad luck, that. Just a bit of over-enthusiasm. And young Duggan, point-blank range, should put up a major for the Island. He does. He taps it through. Goal of Phillip Island. Scores now. Phillip Island, 14 goals, 7. Leading Rovers, 12 goals, 12. That's a difference of 7 points on the Gippsland Building Approval scoreboard. Well, that's the second goal the Island's kicked since half-time, Darryl. The wind's not doing that much again. It's like it's varied all day. I suppose it hasn't been that much of an advantage. Well, survival of the fittest. The umpire bounces the ball. Patching gets the knockout. Hits it on again. Hooper's chasing the ball on. Gets a handball across to Tack. Tack breaks through the pack. Easy as. Kicks it to centre-half forward. Justin Paul comes out. Takes an absolute blinder. He's going to be kicking from the 50-metre line. I'd say it'd be no... The distance shouldn't be a problem, Darryl.
No problem.
No problem at all.
He misses more from 30 than 50.
Yeah. Well, we've seen a great exhibition today. We've seen really two halves of football, the way I see it.
Tony,
first half of Phillip...
Last year,
it is like last year, Darryl. Justin Paul lines him up. He's going to kick from about 55. Long kick right through the middle. It's a goal. It's a goal. It It just got in. 1 point the difference again. We have got a ball game on our hands. And what the time, Darryl?
10 and a half minutes
gone. Is that right? Have we got a ball game on our hands? Okay. Bayer bounces the ball. Bradley had the sit, he had the run there. Rick's caught. Ball smothered. A bit of desperate stuff going on here. McKellar gets the ball out to Young White. Young White gets the ball to Tassari. Tassari's played pretty well across that half forward line today. He's battled in hard, tapped out wide again. Gets the handball running out to Hooper. And Hooper kicks looking for Paul. Nearly took the mark. It was nearly a mark. And he's trying to get rid of the umpire. Said, you better give it to me and I'll ball it up. That was so close to being a mark. It fell down and he just couldn't grab it the second time. Ball punched on. It is through for a point. The scores are level. And boy, we've got a game on our hands. Scores are level. Phillip Island 14-7. Rovers 13-13. I've just been asked who I think will win. Well, you know, anyone can win from this position. It's a grand final, anything can happen in the last quarter, but Rovers have certainly played catch-up football all day through, have gotten our level, and they have played better since the 20-minute mark of the second quarter. The third quarter was all theirs. Ball's thrown in. No one gets a decisive knock. Jai Hart tries to bust his way through the pack. Ball taken by Jones. Handballs it on to Cleary. Cleary running up. Beautiful smother. Taken by Burton. Burton kicks the ball long. Looking for Grace. Dr. Grace nearly at it. His hamstrings are clicking. You can hear him from here. And the ball is now out of bounds. Out of bounds. In the forward pocket. Wonthaggi Rovers attacking now full on. Patching big knock, and he's knocked it out of bounds. Moved it on a little bit further. I'm sick of these close grand finals. I've had a guts full of them. Boundary umpire throws in the ball. Bradley patching. Patching gets the knock. Rovers man never had the ball. Free kick. Burton again. Got to be close to BOG this bloke. Left foot kick, a huge kick. And is it a point? It's a mark, it's a free kick to Grace. Grace runs around, hits the post. Rovers are now in front by a point. Wonthaggi Rovers 13-14. Phillip Island 14-7. 1 point the difference. Kicked out to Patching, who takes a mark at the 50-yard square. Weston, short pass to Weston in front of Burton. The Island are going to have to start to run if they're going to do anything here. Young Bradley. Played all year with Gippsland Power. Showing a little bit of class. On his left foot. Kicks it long. Phillip Island mark taken by Lovett off the pack. Brilliant stuff. The ball bounces to Whale to lose. Whale acting loose man in defence. Looking for someone to kick it to. He really hasn't got many options. And the ball out of bounds. Brad Walker sees it out of bounds.
We're on a win by ball.
Ball thrown in. Bradley and Patching. Patching gets a very decisive knock. Carl Lindsay in front. Threw his head down. Showed a bit of guts there. Taken by Gisberts. Gisberts gets the ball. He's been told to play on. He's been told to play on. He's on his right foot. And oh, magnificent smother by Sean Sturton. They're the one percenters that win grand finals. And that was just great play by Sean Sturton. The crowd's a light here today at Wonthaggi today. 1 point the difference. Rovers have come back from the death to hit the front. The ball is thrown in. Atkinson gets a knockout. White. Burton. 400th kick. Gets the ball up near Lovett. Knockdown. Bradwater smothers it. Jarvis Weston too slow. Tassari. Skill. Back on the left foot. Can Walker mark it? Yes, he can. Brad Walker's got the mark. Runs around, kicks it up high. Gisbert, good punch, good punch. Ricks misses it. McKellar ducks and weaves, shows class. He's got a man tackle all by himself. He's going to run it into the goal square. Long kick in the goal. Where's Justin Paul? Can't mark it. Taps it back into play. Taken by Whale to loose. Never had the ball, and Whale gets a free kick. Wilder loose, looks for someone, finds nobody. And that's marked by Tack again. Shocking kick, but to a running player in Justin Paul. Hit the post. Well, you must remember that Phillip Island hit the post 2 in a row in the first quarter. Pressure's right on here now. Have the Island got the heart to come back? Laurie Howler's brought it back. And it's been paddled out of bounds. That'll suit Rovers because it's in their attacking side. What time do you think it is, Darryl? How long do you reckon's got to go? 5 minutes?
18 minutes gone.
And how long are the quarters these days? 20 minutes?
20.
How long to go there? The ball's been thrown in. Laurie Howe gets a pass to Niven. Quick kick. And a beautiful mark taken by David Jones. David Jones with the ball. Centre wing. The Island have got to make a break. Shocking kick and tack again. He's got loose men running everywhere. Hooper for the ball. He's in front of his man. He's got class, this lad. Handballs it across to Julian Wendell, and Julian Wendell sees Tack again in the centre. He's marked everything. Pierre has been quiet in the last quarter and a half, and was able to smother it out that time. Yeah, Darryl was just saying that anything can happen. Well, it surely can. There's still plenty of time for both sides, are you? Shannon Logan, quick kick. Missed by Fernanda. Hooper again, left foot, looking for Justin Paul. Nearly takes it, Brad Walker gets it, has a bounce. He's running away from them here. Handballs over the top to Whale, who taps it back on a bit luckily there to McIntosh. Brad Walker cops a heavy knock. Jones doesn't know where to go, holding the ball. Young Bradley. Young Bradley's got the ball. Left foot kick. Beautiful kick. Packs for McKellar's in there. Burrowing in as usual. Gets the ball out. Grace plays a bit of soccer. Gisberts can't handle the ball. Gets a quick handball out to Danny Williams. Danny Williams, another handball. There's a bit of a run on now. Loose man created. Danny Williams sees Duggan out the corner of his eye. He should play it on while they're moving. They're slowing down. They've slowed, taken too long. Scott Huther knocked out of it. Jones trying to tap it on. It's taken by Sturton. Rovers got out of jail here. Now they're going into attack. Rovers have taken the ascendancy. The Island had a chance then. Taken by Tack, I think. And Tack kicks it long up in the patching direction. He knocks it out, and it's going to be taken out of bounds. Yes, out of bounds in the forward pocket. Well, went from one extreme to the other. Rob. Five and a half minutes left in the game. Official, Grace, snap. Bounces through for a point, 3 points of difference. There's 5.5 minutes officially left in this game, ladies and gentlemen. No. Patching gets it and kicks it out. Didn't go out on the full, but it was a very poorly directed pass.
Lost their confidence.
The Island got 5 minutes to win a premiership here. They can't have too high. McKellar's free kick. McKellar's got a lot of experience, and he's going to take his time. He's going to suss out where Justin Paul is. Oh, he kicks the ball a country mile. Mark the Rovers in the full forward line. Could that be the sealer? Who is it, Darryl? Tech, is it? Tech. He's taken a number of marks this quarter, Tech. And he's played a great game, actually, Darryl. He's certainly taking his time.
I'll get a cut. Oh, okay.
He puts it straight through the middle. There's about 4 minutes to go. The Island have got to get 2 goals. They're going to have to perform a miracle, Phillip Island, to win this game, I believe, now.
Julian Wintle's gone on to Fernando.
Oh, yeah.
He's done a brilliant job.
Julian Wintle has made a big difference. A big difference. He shut Fernando right out of the game. And that's where the drive was coming from, Darryl. And
third league best of Ferris last year, up in the seniors for his first year.
Yeah.
Great job.
Well, they tried young White first, that didn't work. Wintle next, that has worked. They've shut out the running machine of Phillip Owen. And that has been the difference. Bayer bounces the ball. Patching gets it, knocks it down, it goes to McKellar. McKellar, yet another kick. What's going to happen? The ball's kicked clear. Across the centre forward line. McIntosh overruns the ball. Burton lurking as usual. Ducks his head. And I thought that was a bit soft. He ducked his head into that. Everything's going Rovers' way now.
On his own.
Grace is there all by himself, and he takes the mark.
He won't kick this time.
Well,
he will not kick this.
Darryl reckons he won't kick it. I reckon the fact that he stayed out all day, his probably hamstrings are tightened up a bit more, and he'll get a bit more strength in him, Darryl. In he comes. Shoots for goal. It's a big kick. It's an important kick. That's the winning goal. I'd say it's all over Red Rover now. That's dead.
How's that fat lady going?
It's not over the fat lady since.
On the fat lady.
Yeah, well, it doesn't look good for Phillip Owen. They need three goals now. The scores are 15-16 to 14-7. And it was only minutes to go. Couple of minutes to go. And it'll be all over. And it's looking like a Rovers victory to me. McKellar gets the ball. Handball out. And running all over it. And Ross Lovett. Torpedo in. Punched away by Hauer. Tack again. Couldn't get the ball. Laurie Hauer held. Didn't have it. Handball comes out. Grace has a shot. And Justin Paul just misses the point. The scoreboard reads Rovers 15-17. Phillip Island 14-7. Lead made by Danny Williams. He's contesting hard, not able to get the ball, and he's going to paddle it out of bounds. Siren will go in any minute now. Knocked out by Patching to Gisbert. Held into McKellar. The ball held up. Umpire's going to bounce the ball. Precious time ticking away.
Siren's ready to go.
And the siren is ready to go. Ball bounced. Taken by Sturton. Short kick. Oh, dropped the sitter. Taken by Laurie Hauer. Running up the boundary line. Laurie's had two bounces. Still got enough legs, the old fella. Kicks the ball. Lindsay kicks across to Burt. Brad Walker takes the mark. He's going to have to move the ball quickly. He's going to have to do something, perform miracles. A very poor kick marked by Gisberts. Gisberts goes for the top. Kicks it up high. Punch by Bradley. Fernanda tried to do something then. Curly Marks is out in the clear. Can't get the ball. Yes, he has. He's got a handball out. Out to Duggan. Duggan tackled. And it's all over. The premiership has been won by Rovers again. They have come back from the death, Rovers. They've won this game 15-17 to 14-7. They have won by 16 points. They were 9 goals down at one stage. Nine goals down at one stage, and what a marvellous victory. I have to say, as a Phillip Island supporter, that they deserve their victory. They have come back from when they were absolutely gone for all money, and to their credit, in the second half, they have run on and run on. Wintle shut down Fernanda. Bradley got on top in the ruck. McKellar got a million kicks. Burton has played a great game all day. Hooper's played a great game. Sturton's played a great game. And their prime movers have got this team into another premiership. It's unfortunate to Phillip Island. They were the best team during the year. Unfortunately, they've lost another premiership. That's just the way it goes. Football's a funny game. Grand finals are won on the day, and well, congratulations to Rovers. They've come back honestly from the death. I don't know how in the hell they did it, but they've done it, and by hell, it's a more meritorious victory this year than what it was last year. Darryl, would you like to say a few words? You're a Rovers man. I'd like you to say something. Your club's going to see this video, so what have you got to say?
I think you've done a great job commentating the game, Tony. It was very unbiased, and I don't know, I must have had a feel the way we've described the game. Yeah, it's fallen into Yeah, it's great to see.
Yeah, well, I can understand you're emotional. I remember how emotional you were last year. You were runner for the club last year, Darryl. And thanks, Walt. You were runner for the club last year, and I knew what it meant to you. You've done it 2 years in a row now. You'd be extremely proud of your team. I know Stitchy will be extremely proud of his team. I think the fact that you've come back from the death says a hell of a lot. I mean, you were gone.
Nine goals down.
And I can't believe that you said preliminary final a couple of years ago, exactly the same. Last year, exactly the same. You know, and it's as if it's a recipe. You let the team go ahead and then come back and peg them back and do them.
It's interesting to note the players are still confident at half-time,
yeah.
But actually that's the sorry part too, that somebody's going to lose.
Yeah.
But actually running through the Phillip Island side, I'd be tempted to give Cleary probably your best player.
Yeah, he played very well. He got a lot of possessions all day.
Fernanda was
consistent. Fernanda was the key in the first half, but he didn't go on with it. And
give Julian Wintles.
Well, what a game he played in the second half. He shut Pete Fernanda right out of the game. And then, of course, you had your McKellars that came back into it. Justin Paul came back into it. And Burton was sensational. I thought Burton did a marvellous job. Young Bradley got on top in the end, although Patching played a good last quarter. But what can you say? You can be 9 goals in front and lose a grand final. It's great credit to your team.
Great for the kids, Tony.
Yeah. Well, all right. We'll leave it at that. I hope you've enjoyed our telecast of today's game. It's done by amateurs, but nevertheless, I hope the Rovers enjoyed what you saw. I hope Phillip Island enjoyed what they saw. It's been a real good day. We've seen a lot of great football. And as it turned out, the team that won the premiership was the best team of the day because they had the biggest job in front of them, and they come up and they did credit to their supporters and to themselves. And it's commiserations to Phillip Island. I thought how far at quarter time. I think we all thought how far. It didn't happen. Football's a funny game. It's a great game, football, Darryl. And to see the way that it's turned out, well, I would never have believed it. But I believe it now because you believed in it right at the start.
We're going down there.
OK. No, we're not. Thank you very much for the telecast. Hope you enjoy your video. And commiserations to Phillip. Commiserations to Phillip Island. And commiserations to Phillip Island. And congratulations to Rovers. Thanks for having me. And I hope you're not sick of my voice. It's Tony's own Eddie and Darryl signing off from the 1995 Grand Final.
Where is he? Thanks, Alex. think Phillip Island for the game. Thank our blokes for fighting it out. We could have easily chucked in the towel half time, but we did. And I'd like to thank Dusha, because Dusha at the start of the game said, I'm going to get you, give you the 3 votes. So thanks, Dusha.
Thank you. the offsider.
Absolutely sensational, Harold.
Is it better than buying, not buying in the grand final?
That's a tough question, eh?
top. I want to interview you. How
are you doing? Daryl Curtis, how does it feel to be part of this great win today?
It is probably a better win than last year, much better win than last year.
What makes you say that, Daryl?
Well, to come from 9 goals down, last year we come from 5 goals down. If we go back and have a look at the interview I've done before the match, I've actually wrote a script to it. I said that Phillip might have probably jumped us, but we will have the ability to come back and kick us.
Thank you, Daryl.